Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week I'm going to show you a few tips and tricks on using your notes app with your phone and how you can actually help get Siri to help you get notes into your notes app. Now, before we go any further, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Apple's productivity system, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my Notes app and Siri and show you how I get the most out of using Notes on my phone. Okay, let's get started off with some fun with Siri. So, hey Siri, show me my notes from this week.
I found 4 items from last Monday to today at 1:46 p.m.
So there we go. So what Siri's going to do there is she's actually going to start reading the notes out. But you can actually say, show me my notes from the last 2 days. Show me my notes from today. You can do anything you like. Now, this is really good. If you're using an iPad and you're doing your weekly planning session, you could just use Siri and just say, hey, Siri, show me my notes from this week. And she will just to make sure that you haven't missed anything. Now, something else that I like to do is we've got something here, which is just from the Golden Eye Resort, which is an amazing resort that I one day want to visit. And what I can do is I can sort of say, oh, I like this picture. And I can now just tap on the picture, add share, tap notes, and I can actually just create a new note from that, from there down the bottom, and save. Now that picture now is in my cloud. iCloud storage is full, so I'm not able to, but I can go straight to that picture. So that's just something else that you may want to do. You can just create pictures from that. That's absolutely fantastic. And go back to my we'll go back to my notes, and there you go. So that's something that you can use with collecting stuff into your notes. Another one that you can do with Siri is, hey Siri, update my last note.
I found a few options.
So
which note do you want to
So
edit?
What I would need to do is I type on that.
Okay, what would you like to add?
I would really like to stay here.
Okay, I added I would really like to stay here. To your notes, Spanish Elm 2.
There you go. So you can do all sorts of things within notes. And I would strongly recommend that you have a lot of practice. Just play around with this. It's really, really good, the things that you can do with your notes app. And so this is just one of the things that you may wish to do. And I've got things like here. I've got a goals note down here and I've got a shopping note down here. So I can say, hey Siri, show me my notes containing goals.
Item about goals. Your note from today called goals says, climb the Matterhorn, stay at Golden Eye Visit.
So that's one of those things that you could actually create a list with your goals or even with your objectives for the week, and then you could create a Siri shortcut for her to actually read that out to you every morning as part of your morning routine. So there's a lot of like really interesting things that you can do with these things. So I've got one. Now the problem is you can actually go, hey Siri, take a note. And what's going to happen with my application is I've got a Siri shortcut and this will open up my drafts app so that I can actually collect a note from the dictation. And it does that without me having to touch anything, full stop. And I find that drafts is a much better dictation tool simply because there is no time limit on this, full stop, if it's that new paragraph. If you start this in Siri Notes, what will happen is you will find that you are cut off after 45 seconds. So there you go. And then all I need to do is create that note. It will do, and I can open up the share sheet and I can share it to my notes and I can just create a new note and bang, that creates a new note and save. Job done. So that's something that you can do. Now, if I'm going to take you into my Siri shortcuts, I don't want to do a too big a tutorial on this, but this is this particular one here. Oops, cancel that. What I have to do is go back to my shortcuts. This is dictate a new draft. And I created this, if you're using the Drafts app, I created this using the Drafts Siri shortcuts, and it will just create a new note. And all I did was, hey Siri, take a note, and that's, she will do that. And so that's just a really good tip that you want to use. If those of you using Todoist, sorry, those of you using Drafts, that's something that you can do. And as you can see down here, I've got all sorts of little things that I've actually been practicing with, but that's not something I will cover. I will cover shortcuts in a later one. But if you use the phrase, hey Siri, take a note, she will actually start taking a note directly into your notes app. Just on my phone, I've got a Siri shortcut with using that phrase. So there you go. There's just some little things that you can use notes with Siri, and just a few other things that you can use notes for. These are just really great time-saving things that you can use, and I hope you've got some ideas to use this from yourself. Like I said, I will cover some basic shortcuts that you can use in a coming episode, but for now, that's really what I wanted to do, just to finish off using Siri with reminders and notes. And hopefully you found some use out of this. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I'd like to introduce you to a brand new way of managing your tasks. Now, this system is called the Time Sector System. It's designed to do away with your projects, to do away with your goals, or at least do away with them from your time management system, your to-do list manager, and instead focuses on when you are going to do the task. Now, the reason for this is from a research that I did for the whole of last year, figuring out why most people were really struggling with their tasks, getting their tasks done on a day-to-day basis. What I discovered was they were managing their tasks by project. And the biggest problem with managing tasks by project is, first of all, deciding whether a task is a project or not. Two or more tasks becomes a project, which means that you end up with a huge project list. And once you have a huge project list, just managing that list takes up an awesome amount of time. Time you could well better be spent actually doing the work, not organizing. The time sector method is designed to do away with all that processing so that the only decision you have to make is when are you going to do a task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, how urgent a task is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. So the whole clip, this, I have launched a brand new course that gives you the step-by-step approach of setting up the time sector method. It's a revolutionary course. It's designed for the 21st century, for all the inputs that we get today, all the emails, the Slack messages, and everything else that comes our way. It's designed to deal with that, to manage that, so you stay focused on what you have identified are your most important tasks for the day. I'd love to see you in the course. Full details of the course are in the show notes below. I'd love you to check it out. Join me in the course and let's take your productivity to a greater level than you've ever, ever imagined. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. I just wish you all a very, very productive week.